Students, your revision schedule has been shared with you. Topics have been done, right? And you know, it is Monday. So you're going to prepare accordingly. So we have enough time this week to do our revision nicely. So in a way, you're lucky, you know, you've got one full week for revision. So we can discuss the topics. Okay, I've written Tuesday because next Monday, in case it's a holiday, then your test would be shared on Tuesday. Okay, so you'll be there are two revision tests. Right? So you will be having two revision tests, right? And multiple choice questions. And right, of all the topics you will get. You will have from your grammar and writing and your literature. For your reading comprehension, I have shared with you. Please do that. Write down the answers and be ready. I'll discuss it in the class tomorrow, okay? Right, and you might do some other comprehension passages I can share with you and we'll just do it. Now, before I proceed with our revision and what are the things that I want to tell you today, we're going to discuss the listening test also. I'll be sharing a video with you, right? And after 5 minutes, I will share a link, right? And you have to fill in your responses, your one-line answers and whatever, enough space is there given where you can write down. Do not write unnecessarily. Do not panic. Don't send me screenshots of your answers, right? If you responded automatically, it would be there in the Google form, okay? Right? And for your safety, if you want to, you can take a screenshot that I have attempted the test, okay? Fine, and that's it, right? So I will just go through your responses and you will be given your marks accordingly. So it is there, a simple, easy task. And if you're absent, you're going to be marked zero. Now today we start off on the popular request of you all to discuss the chapter Anne Frank, okay? Right, although, you know, like there is nothing so difficult about this chapter. It is about a small incident, you know, that lively incident that this young girl has recorded in her diary, right? And of course, here you have to know, you know, like when you talk about diary, we think the diary is something that we write every day, right? Or about incidents that have affected, right? And when we talk about a collection of our personal experiences, so we have people there writing their memories, they write about important incidents that take place. So it becomes a memoir, right? So when you talk about your memories, when you talk about incidents that have happened. Now, this chapter, it starts with Anne giving an introduction about herself. So she does a very wise way of writing it. So she writes a diary here. She's given the introduction and she talks about her family, right? And why she started writing the diary. Who gave her the diary? Her grandmother gave her the diary. And how old was she when she got the diary? She was 13 years old. All of you open your book and look at the first page there. Everything is there. And as I ask you questions, I expect answers also, right? So which page is it? Page 50, I think so. Yeah, 49, 50. Open to page 50. Writing in a diary is a really strange experience. Found it? Yes. Now over there, just find out. Just tell me, how old was Anne when she started writing? 13 year old. Okay, right. And what were the things that she wanted to get off her chest? To get all kinds of things off my chest. What is it? What happens to you when you get things off your chest? Yes? You feel relaxed because you've spoken to someone. You've talked to someone, right? You maybe written about it. So that burden which was there on your heart, on your mind, it has been taken away, okay? So you feel relaxed that, yes, I have, you know, talked about it. And who are they, the people who help you to get relaxed and you are able to get things off your chest? Your friends, right? So why do you think Anne had to write in the diary? She did not have friends, right? So, and of course, when you talk about a 13-year-old and the diary entry that we have read or about her memoirs, where she's a chatterbox, it's very difficult to believe that she did not have friends, right? So paper has more patience than people. What is the attitude of people towards teenagers? Do you think people listen to teenagers? Yeah. Elders listen? Parents, do they listen? Friends listen? Isn't it? They have, like, because we're all in the same boat. Yeah, you're all going to pass and fail together. So that is why you think, okay, they're going to listen to us. And we're facing the problems of life. And your problems, it seems when you're a teenager, your problems are much, much bigger than the problem that the people are facing in the world. Right? We're not bothered about global warming. We're not talking about environment conservation. We're not talking about all, you know, like, of course, whether people are getting vaccinated or not. We have our own set of problems. Right? So we have our own little weird, you know, things there. Once again, see, I'm also talking about like that in a very condescending tone, as if teenagers, you know, like, don't have problems. Yeah, you have a lot of problem, okay? Right? You have a pimple on your face. You're growing taller. Your voice is changing, right? Of course, your friend is not talking to you. You couldn't submit your homework on time. There are so many things that we need to discuss. And why does mommy cook the same boring food every day? Right? Yes, and you have a lot of homework. You have so many assignments, so many tests. What a life we have. We have such a busy life. Nobody understands. So teenagers have so many problems. So they need people to talk to. They need people who can listen to them. But they don't find people who listen to them. So what has Anne Frank decided to do? Sensible girl she was. She started writing in her diary. She did have friends. But those friends were the kind that she could not share, you know, her problems with, the ones that she could not share her issues with, or because they were like you all only, right? So we are there, we laugh together, we have our problems together, but when it comes to, you know, like, yes, maybe understanding or giving some suggestion or advice, we are, of course, maybe not so good at it, right? We admit it, okay? I didn't say it, you only said it yourself. Right? So we are there because our attitude or our perspective of life is very different. So that is why. And paper has more patience than people. Paper does not speak. Paper does not reply. Paper does not get up and walk away. It will listen. And yes, so she could write as much as she want to. Right? I thought of this saying on one of those days when I was feeling a little depressed. What does depressed mean? Yeah, stressed. Depressed means you're stressed out. What else does it mean? You're feeling low, you're feeling unhappy, right? Okay, and yes, here, like, yeah, depressed here. We use it very lightly, you know, this word. We use it quite often, right? So here it is, yeah, you're not happy, right? So when you're unhappy, of course, instead of saying that, you say, oh God, I'm feeling a little depressed. I'm feeling a little low. I was sitting at home with my chin in my hands, bored and listless. What does listless mean? Yes, like lifeless, right? So she said, doesn't want to do anything. Wondering whether to stay in or go out. I finally stayed where I was brooding. Yes, paper does have more patience. And since I'm not planning to let anyone else read this stiff-backed notebook, grandly referred to as a diary, unless I should ever find a real friend, it probably won't make a lot of difference. So who has she made her friend? Her diary is her friend because she's going to talk to her diary. She's going to write in a diary. And she says, still, I don't find a friend. And because of her nature, she thinks that it's going to be very difficult for her to find a friend. Is her diary a special book? What is special about it? No, but like when you talk about a diary, what should it look like? What should a diary be? You know, like, can I use an ordinary notebook as a diary? No, I can't use an ordinary. No, I need to go to the market and especially ask for a diary. I want to write diary, so please give me one. Then where do I write my thoughts? What kind of a book is a diary? What kind of a stationery item is it? Yes? Yes? A simple notebook can also be a diary. What did she get from her grandmother? She got this notebook, right? And she, because she had a beautiful relationship with her grandmother, she was very close to her grandmother. So she decided that I am going to use this notebook for a special purpose, right? So she's not going to keep it for her class notes or something like that, but she's going to keep it something very special. So that means she's giving that present that she got so much of importance. So a diary is not a special book that you have to go and buy. So any register you pick up where you start writing and you continuously write in that, right? So you at least have a separate notebook, you know, where you're going to write all your thoughts and your ideas. So she has this notebook. Now, why has she started writing the diary? We know that she does not have any friends. What does she have to say about her family? What does she tell about her family? Who all are there in her family? So her grandmother was there, her father, mother, and her elder sister. So elder sister is 16 years old, right? And yes, so what about them? What about them? Do they listen to her? No. And she has a long extended family, big extended family. Also, the relatives there, her aunts are there. Another, you know, like, yes, we all have members there. But she does not find anyone whom she can talk to. Okay? Right. So do you think she's a difficult person to get along with? People who don't make friends easily, is it very difficult to understand them? Yes? Why? Why? Because you don't talk, you don't know what they're thinking about. Is it? That's why? They can't share their problems, or they think they can't share. So maybe they've not reached that comfort level. So as it is, once again here, we might be on the surface, very talkative, very chirpy and laughing around. But yes, when it comes to sharing our problems or our personal lives, we don't go around sharing it with everyone. Unless and until we do it on social media nowadays, feeling lonely, feeling sad, feeling depressed, okay, want to have tea, coffee, whatever. That is what we keep on sharing. We love doing things like this, isn't it? Right? So you get that support from your friends and they make you feel happy and you don't feel sad anymore, isn't it? Right? So yeah, so we should not share, you know, like our personal lives with everyone. So as it is, there are just a selected few people whom we are comfortable with. But Anne was not even comfortable with anyone. She could not find someone whom she could be talking to. Right? So yes, so what is it? So that's why she has started the diary. Okay, and what does she name the diary? Kitten. Okay, so he named her diary Kitty. Kitty is the name of a diary. Okay. Have you ever tried writing a diary? Yes. Have there ever been days in your life, oh my God, you feel like, yes, this is a very life-changing moment for me. I want to talk about it. Or sometimes you feel, oh my God, this is the day when I'm going to become a famous writer. Let me do something. Is it? But yes, there are times when you do want to write down something. But nowadays, as I said, we share most of our things on hashtags, isn't it? Right? So you have that. Okay? But even that takes a lot of courage. Takes a lot of courage, you know, you want to share, you know, a part of your life, you want to share something so important and you want to of course, one thing that you should be very, very careful about is, yes, you might get negative feedback also. So you have to take that negative feedback with a pinch of salt, you know, you asked for it, you're getting that response, right? So the people are going to make fun of you also, so you learn to adjust with that. Okay, so it's not a nice place here when you talk about the social networking, where not all people are kind and understanding, right? So what was the name of her diary? Kitty. We're never going to forget this now, isn't it? Right? So Kitty was her diary and she's talking about a family. Now she's giving a detailed sketch about her family. What does she talk about? Yes, her father, her mother, her sister Margaret, and where were they born? in Germany, Frankfurt. Okay. Then there is one more aspect about her life. When we talk about Germany, we also know that Anne Frank was a Jew, right? And we know that how the Germans were there, anti-Jew policies they had. And at a young age, she had experienced that discrimination. And at a young age, how her family had to go into hiding to save themselves. So already, maybe these are the things that she wanted to talk about. But she felt nobody is going to understand. Now, just imagine how a 13-year-old child might be feeling that you're targeted for belonging to a certain community, right? And you hear about people there taken away. They are sent away to concentration camps. They are, targeted for belonging to this community. So it's not a nice thought. Maybe that is why she did not get close to many people, or she did not have friends, right? So she lived in Frankfurt. And then where did they emigrate to? Which country did they emigrate to? Holland, yes. And we talk about Amsterdam, and that is where she lived her last days of her life. And there is a museum in her name, and Anne Frank is a very iconic figure over there, right? So she is one of the most celebrated figures of the Holocaust, as we call it. So the war or the killing, the mass killings which were there of the Jews, right? Yes. And did she accompany her parents to Holland, or she joined them later? She joined them later, right? And in the meanwhile, where did they stay? They stayed with their grandmother. That is why she was more closer. And of course, her elder sister went before her, and later on she followed, okay? Right? And then she talks about her school, right? She talks about a Montessori school, and she stayed there till she was six, and then she started in the first form. And in the sixth form, what was the teacher's name? Mrs. Cooperus. Okay. And why were they both in tears, when she left school? When it was a heartbreaking farewell, and both of them in tears. Why? Because she was leaving, and she liked her teacher. It was difficult for her to say goodbye to her. Then what happened in 1941? Grandma fell ill, and she had to have an operation, and naturally her birthday was not celebrated that year. Then her grandmother passed away in 1942. And how did she celebrate a birthday there? So she lit a candle for her grandmother, once again showing that how attached she was, right? And of course, so now who are the four members in the family? Her parents, her elder sister Margaret, and Anne Frank. Okay, right. And she started writing the diary at the age of 13. Okay, yes. Now let us move on here. What does Anne tell about her class, and what are the students all afraid of? Quaking. What does it mean, quaking in its boots? They are scared, they're nervous, right? Okay. So what are they worried about? What are they? So what were the students scared of? What were the students scared of? They're worried about the results, right? And what will happen when the results are declared? Students will be promoted. Some might be detained, right? And what are they very scared of? What are they worried about? That about the teacher's behavior. What does she call her teachers about? What does she talk about the behavior? Yes, what does she say about them? They are most unpredictable creatures. You can't say how they, like the student who is expected to pass might be detained, and the student who is expected to be detained might be passed, right? Or moving on to the next class. So what were the children doing about this? What were they doing here regarding their results? So they were betting on it, and they're making their own guesses, right? So wondering here, and which subject scared her? That was maths. Okay, so she's worried about that. But yes, so she's quite sure that she will pass and she'll move on to the next class. But she's worried about one subject in particular. Are you also worried about maths? Anyone? Yeah? Yes, right. And of course, it's a, once again, about a presence of mind, about numbers, and about how clear you are in your thoughts and ideas, isn't it, right? And here, yes, it's another subject that you have to study. But yeah, you need a lot of practice for it. That is why you think. So what does she say about her teachers? How many teachers does she have? How many teachers does she have? There are 9 of them. 7 men and 2 women. And what does she have to say about Mr. Keith Singh? He was a maths teacher. He was quite strict. And why was he so upset with her? Why was he upset with her? She didn't get marks? Now she read the chapter. Read the chapter. She talked a lot. And how do teachers behave with students who talk a lot? They should be punished. Yes, to make them keep quiet. Yes, right. And so Mr. Keith Singh, what kind of punishment did he give? Yes, so he made her write an essay. What was the essay? On a chatterbox. What would you write on a chatterbox? Who's the chatterbox? Why people talk so much? What are the effects of talking? How is it good? You know, if you're a chatterbox, you talk about the benefits of talking. What are the disadvantages of not talking? Yeah. What is there? If you had to write an essay about it, what would you include? You have to? You'll feel bored if you don't talk. Okay, good point. What else? So we are in school, we have to talk to your friends, right? Coming to school means talking with friends, right? Yes. Yeah, so we will feel depressed. We want to talk to our friends, yes? You can't share. So that is why, right? But a chatterbox is one who talks too much, isn't it? And do you have a friend who's a chatterbox who go on and on and on? So we're all turning around and looking at someone. Okay. So we have identified a chatterbox of the class. It might be many might be a few sitting at home also, right? Yeah. And a chatterbox, do you think can talk anywhere? In the classroom, at home, with family, friends, anywhere? Or a chatterbox is comfortable with his or her own friends only? Anywhere? Anywhere. Okay, right. So a chatterbox does not bother about the environment or the atmosphere where he is or she is. They can start talking because they love to talk. But don't you think it's a gift to talk so much? It's a gift. Yeah, not many people have that gift, isn't it? Right? Talking about anything and everything and talking anywhere and everywhere. Right? Yeah. Right. So, of course, here, yes, so he gave her an essay to write on a chatterbox. So, we have discussed maybe these were some of the things that she could have or she would have written in her essay, right? Then, of course, so she talks about how she did the assignment. Mr. Keith Singh was there, quite satisfied. But as students do, you know, teenagers, they think we've been punished. Now I can do the same mistake again. Right, my teacher has given me punishment. I wrote the essay. Now I'm back in the class. I can keep on talking. Is this what happens? What is a punishment meant for? To stop that thing. So did Anne take it as a punishment? No. She thought, I've done my duty. I've written the essay. I can keep on talking now. Right? I've justified my behavior. I cannot keep quiet. Then what does she talk about in the next essay? What reason does she give? Is chattering something genetic? Does it have? But she gives that reason that, okay, because my mother talks a lot, I can't control it. It's in the family. But not necessarily, you know. Sometimes you have their parents who are quite talkative and the child might be quite quiet, isn't it? Right? But she gives that. Is the teacher convinced? Does she change? Does she stop talking? Then what is that here? Final essay, you know? Yes, another assignment. Quack, quack goes the chatterbox. A chatterbox, an incorrigible chatterbox. Then quack, quack goes the chatterbox. Okay. And that was one which changed the thinking of a teacher. Sometimes you keep on stopping a child from showing his natural behavior. You are making a child behave in a very unnatural way. And she gives that. She gives that justification. And what does the duck do? What does the duck do when she talks about quack, quack goes the chatterbox? He bit his, the ducklings. You know, he hurt them. And in a way, she's trying to tell the teacher that if you keep on telling me to keep quiet, you are snubbing me. You're stopping my natural behavior, okay? So this is about the discussion of the chapter. Tomorrow, we'll discuss the multiple choice questions. Before that, I will discuss the reading comprehension. I want you to be ready with the answers. And students at home, you will share the screen and you will show me that you have written the answers. Okay, so no excuses at all. We're going to spend today doing English. So see you all tomorrow.